What's up guys, Kamil here from Addictive Frames. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a clock animation, which you can use, let's say, for this effect. So let's go. Okay guys, this is a node tree that I created for this animation. You can find it in description below. Let's go back to edit page. I want fusion to be 13 seconds long. So I'm going to grab fusion composition and I'm going to hit Ctrl D and I will type in 1, 3, enter. And this is the same length. And let's go inside to Fusion. So I will start with alpha 0 background connected to media out. Next will be white background. I will name it white PG. I'll connect it here to background. I want to hit Ctrl G. That will have a guides. And I'm going to grab this ellipse, uncheck solid and make border with. And I forgot to crank alpha to 1 and change the color to white, because in default every background I grab is alpha 0. So we've got outline, let's adjust it to these lines, and actually I hit here equal, and that I will have expression and connected height to width, and every time I move width the height go along. And next I'm going to copy this background, paste it here. And I'm going to grab this ellipse and I'm going to hit equal here and do the same what I've done in last ellipse. Actually, I could copy this, but anyway, I've got solid. I need solid ellipse now, so make it smaller. Okay, like that. And move it about here. Make it a bit smaller. I will position it here. Let's do 0.93. I will uncheck show view controls. I'm going to select white PG and hit shift space and type in duplicate, and we will need 12 copies of that, and we're going to do -30. Next I'm going to copy this white background, paste it here, connect it to this merge. I'm going to copy this ellipse, select this background, paste ellipse here, and I'm going to make this dots a bit smaller, and I'm going to duplicate, and I need 60 copies, and I'm going to do angle to -6, and let's do this a little bit smaller, let's say like that. Now we're going to create hours, so from 1 to 12, and I found many ways to do that. Anyway, we need a text for this. Let's connect the text, and I change the name for this text hours, and I change fonts to Helvetica, and that will be bold. So anyway, we need 12 hours, so 1, 2, 3, 4. And now let's change size to 0.06. We go into click here, right mouse button, and that will be character level styling. And let's start from 12. So highlight this 12, go to transform and adjust this way every number position, every number on clock. Believe me guys, this is the most efficient way I've found to make it. Okay, numbers are located on its place. I guess I'm gonna show you how I made it before, what I was trying to. To be honest, I spent hours to make it better. What I've done, I went to layout, change it to path, I changed it to circle, and then I went to transform and I changed spacing. And actually from characters, we needed to change it to word, otherwise the numbers 11 and 12 will be stretched. So let's go to words and imagine you did this. And actually there is no way to do it precisely. For some reason in DaVinci, there is no way to do it in some mathematical way. And I was really struggling. As you can see, even if 12 and 1 is nearly on the position, as you can see, 6 is not, 7 and not, and you could adjust endlessly. I found the other way. I don't want to explain, it's even more complicated. So this is the closest way to do it, but for me it's not doable. So the most efficient way to position these numbers is as I showed you with character level styling modifier. Okay, so when we've got the hours and we've got numbers and all points, now we're going to select this ellipse and background, copy, paste it here, and let's go with this ellipse here in the middle. Let's untick show view controls. Let's do it 0.01. Okay, so we've got this circle in the middle. Now we're going to create hand hours. For this purpose, I need copy white background again, connect it here and select white background again. And let's grab polygon, uncheck solid, let's leave border style on rounded, and I'm going to increase border width, and I'm going to point polygon. Actually, it needs to be show view controls, so I'm going to start somewhere here, and holding shift, I'm going to drop hours here, and unthick show view controls, and make it a bit thicker. And now we're going to create hand minutes. Copy this, paste it here. That will be hand minutes. So this one is hand hours, this hand minutes. So let's actually name it. Let's select this node, hand minutes, hold shift, grab this point and go a little bit up with that. And I would like to change border width, make it thinner, uncheck show view controls. And to outstand from the hours, I was thinking to change the color that indicates minutes. So I'll grab blue one. You can change it if you want. And actually I need to replace hours. It needs to be on top of the minutes. And actually the minutes, I make it a little bit longer. So again, hold shift and grab the point. I think it's enough. And now I want this hand hours and minutes, this hands, be below the circle. To do that, I'm going to copy this ellipse, click on empty space here, hold Ctrl Shift V, and I'm going to invert the instance solid and the instance border width. Now I'm going to connect this instance ellipse to these two merges, and now I'm going to invert and make it solid. And now, as you can see, the hands stay behind this circle. Okay, so far so good. Our clock is ready. Now we're going to animate that. So we need the transport here and here. And when we grab angle in minutes, you see it will go around. What we need to do, we need to link these angles in transforms. Let's name it, that's gonna be transform minutes, and the second one will be transform hours. And I want to make them outstand, like so. I'm gonna animate them, so that's why I want to make them bigger. When I always come back to Fusion Composition, I know what's going on. And by the way, I wanna do 12 hours animation. I mean, it's not gonna take. And I wanna do 12 hours. And I wanna do 12 hours animation. So the hours transform angle will go around, like this, right? So that's gonna be -360. So -360, and let's go to frame 280. First frame 0, and hit diamond here, and go to frame 280, and type in here -360. So as you can see, the hours, that will be 12 hours session, okay? And now we need to connect transform minutes angle to transform hours angle. So I'm going to pin transform minutes, and I'm going to pin transform hours. And transform minutes is animated already. And I want to hit equal here, so we're gonna have expression. And I wanna link angle from transform minutes to angle of transform hours, okay? And they go along. They connected already. But what to do to spin minutes 12 times faster? It's very simple, guys. Look at this. We go into minutes and we're going to type in times 12. And when you move when you start the animation, as you can see, it's perfect. And for better look of this clock, I'm going to drop shadow here after last merge. And if you want to, you can add soft glow to hours. You can add soft glow anywhere for better look, but it's your animation. You can create it as you wish. Thank you very much for watching. See you guys in the next one. Bye.